Bonjour, welcome back to the 2016 International Division 1 Playoffs from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. I am AK 40 Ounce here with the Derby Nerd. What have we got here?
This is what we are playing for right here, the first place trophy at the Montreal Division 1 tournaments.
There's these
the
as well.
Hardware right there. Absolutely beautiful. This is actually really heavy, too. Yeah. Yes, we are here for the final game, the championship game of the first Division 1 weekend of 2016. And we have the number one seed, London Rollergirls, London Brawling, taking on the second seed, Texas Rollergirls. London comes in ranked third in the Wftda. The legendary Texas Rollergirls come in ranked sixth. And it's been an absolutely amazing performance from both of these teams this weekend, living up to their top billing.
That's right, and a journey for both of them. Of course, they did have byes into the quarterfinals. Well, not byes necessarily, but they played a team that had already played in the weekend. London defeating Detroit to move on to the semis against Montreal, and now that brings them here. On the other side of things, Texas taking down Rocky Mountain and then Bay Area. So these two teams do have some history at both divisional playoffs and at championships.
Yeah, absolutely. These two teams, they last played in June 2015 at Pack Destruction, with London coming out on top 166 to 134. Both these teams are legendary in their own right. Texas Rollergirls, of course, the founding members of the flat track game. And the London Rollergirls, the first ever non-North American team to advance to the playoffs. And, of course, they finished fourth in the last two WFTDA championship tournaments.
Well, an opportunity to finish first here for both of these squads. Again, not only this, that wonderful trophy, but a bye at Champs on the line.
That's right. That first round bye, of course, critically important. Having to play that playing game can be a grueling process. And so I think each of these teams wants that number one seed. They felt what it's like to get a sort of bye, as you mentioned, into the quarterfinal round here at Montreal. I'm sure they'd like to continue that in Portland as well in November.
That's right, and we are waiting for the rollouts. But Dave, just some more thoughts on these two teams this weekend and what we can expect coming into this game.
Well, both these teams have had, I think, relatively quiet years. London just played 5 sanctioned games this year. They went 4-1. Texas played 10 games, and they went 6-4. But both have come in, I think, playing at the top of their game.
Yes.
The London defense has been absolutely unbelievable. Their dominance over Montreal last night, I think, shocked some people. Yeah. I don't think anyone was expecting Montreal perhaps to pull off the upset, but I think the way in which London dominated was pretty thorough and pretty shocking. We saw the same thing with Texas in that opening game in the quarterfinals against the Rocky Mountain Rollergirls. These are two teams that have a deep shared history, and Texas just absolutely dominated that. 29 and a half minutes of shutout roller derby to kick off that game. That is absolutely unbelievable. Did get challenged a little bit by Bay Area, but nonetheless, both these teams are rolling. Deep jammer rotations, really, really solid packs. These are two rosters that are loaded with roller derby superstars, some of the most famous names in the game.
That is right, and speaking of which, might as well talk about those names. First off, Texas will take the floor for their introduction. Olivia Shootin' John, number 3, number 07, Jackie Daniels. CC Boom, number 100. 108, Fifi Nominon. Number 15, Drama. 1600 is Barbara Ambush. Bloody Mary, number 20. Freight Train, 202. Peace War, number 27. 420 is Stoner. Smarty Pants, Rocks, number 5. Hoss the Boss, number 55. Bittercup, 813. And Dolores Fuente. Is 888. They are Texas, they are in white, and they are the 2 seed.
Freight Train leading the way in scoring for Texas this weekend with 180 points over 2 games, averaging 11.3 points per jam. Bloody Mary, though, the veteran, having a clutch weekend. She has a 92% lead percentage over 2 games. Incredibly impressive performance from her. Some other really impressive numbers. Fifi Nominon, one of the 4 skaters on Texas to have over 100 points here in the tournament. But Hoss the Boss, who did not play in the first game for Texas, came through huge in the second game, scoring 70 points on an 89% lead percentage.
Not skating in this game, but here with the Texecutioners, number 12, DeBella DeBall, number 19, Molotov and Pale. 2-1-2 is Killams, 34, Bo Jackson, and Nikki Tiki Timebomb, number 9.
Nikki did play in the opening game of this tournament. put in 34 points and had a plus 22 in that victory over Rocky Mountain. All right, and next up, the number one seed, the third-ranked team in the WFTDA, the current fourth-place holders at the WFTDA champion, London Rollergirls, the London Brawling. Number 111, Arocha. Number 13, Stephanie Maney. Number 16, Anne Dracula. Number 18, Jukebox. Number 2, Master Blaster. Number 22, Rogue Runner. Number 3, Onyeka Igwe. Number 40, Kid Block. Number 51, Olivia Coop. Number 55, Lexi Lightspeed. Number 7, Kristen Lee. Number 77 is Die Die. Number 8008 is Philosophia Jason Smith. Number 84 is Katie Helvetica Black. And number 888 is Shaolin Scarlet. And here, but not skating, will be Sophia and Loathing, Minnie Ross, Carly McAdam, Trisha Smackinawa, Little Bo Creep, and Kristen Lee. On the bench will be Ballistic Whistle, the best bench coach, and the assistant coach is Techno. That is your London Roller Girls, London Brawling.
Our referees for this game will be Patricide, the crew head. On the inside with Reverend Riot, Deuce Willis, and Matt S. Faction will be the jammer referees. Penny Whistler, Direwolf, Cleveland on the outside, and Judge Double Wapner, the referee alternate.
And as we mentioned, both these teams already booking their ticket to Portland. We just saw Montreal do so in thrilling fashion as well against Bay Area Derby Girl. And now the last thing that remains to be determined is who will be our number one seed coming out of Montreal. Moments away now, and on the Fast Girl State start line, it's going to be Lexi Lightspeed, number 55 for London in the black. And she will be facing off against Fifi Nominon, number 108 in the white for Texas. Hard to believe that Fifi Nominon almost retired from roller derby or from the Texecutioners.
Well, did for a brief period of time. I think the allure of playoffs and missing the competition may have been what brought her back.
And she has not missed a step. Had a great season just coming into the last two games, scoring 61 points in the regular season, putting in 103 over the two games this weekend on a 67% lead percentage. So here we are, final game of the 2016 WFTDA International Division I playoffs here from Montreal, now underway.
Fifi Nominon starting with the star, pushing up against London's braced two wall out in front.
Seeing some of that grueling defense right from the start here, that London tripod able to move around so efficiently.
Now some offense for Texas. Great job by there by CC Boom to break things up, but a good recycle by London. They will lose Kid Block to the box, but out first, London lead jammer Lexi Lightspeed.
Nice move by Lexi Lightspeed. Just took a few steps back, built up some speed, and was able to jump through that block from Texas.
Texas still having difficulty freeing their jammer Fifi Nominon, but now, with a spin move and some amazing balance work, Fifi Nominon is clear, but with 4 points and calling it off, Lexi Lightspeed trailed behind.
Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in the roller skating industry for over 70 years. Find out more at rydellskates.com. Well, what a start, AK. Seeing some of that incredible London defense locking things down, just as it seemed like Fifi Nominon was going to break through for lead jammer status, really shut things down and buying Lexi Lightspeed just enough time to get through.
Next jam, we'll see Rogue Runner with the star up against Haas the Boss. Barbara Ambush in the box for Texas London with Kid Block seated in the penalty box two.
CC Boom now back on the track. Penalty is over. Kid Block is standing in the box as well.
Shaolin Scarlet still seated. Run back there by Die Die, but Haas the Boss is lead jammer for Texas.
Haas the Boss now one for one.
Early penalty trouble as Jukebox now headed to the penalty box for London. Nice move on the inside, a little hop to finish it off, and 5 points go up for Haas the Boss.
Early on, but we've got our first lead change already now, 5-4 for Texas.
Haas taking a shoulder shot there from Shaolin Scarlet, now locked in behind London's defense. Barbara Ambush occupying Die Die in hopes that Haas can get through. Ambush now throwing shoulder in to Kid Block, and that helps Haas the Boss find room on the inside for a grand slam.
And Stonehur heading to the penalty box for Texas just as Jukebox exits, so pack advantage now shifts to London.
Rogue Runner out on the initial pass. Here comes Haas the Boss on the third scoring pass. Trauma spinning around, mixing things up, and Haas will push through for 1 point. 11 on that jam, and Texas takes the lead 11-4 here. 2:40 gone in the first half.
888 helmets, pads, wrist guards. We've got you covered at 888.com. Coming up to the Fast Girl Skates start line now. First opportunity with the Stars, and Dracula is having an unbelievable weekend, leading London in scoring. I don't know if a lot of people were predicting that coming in, and she will face off against the veteran Olivia Shootin'John.
Olivia Shootin'John shoots right into a braced two-all from London. Meanwhile, up front, fast feet, working back and forth, trying to find room through, and she does, and Dracula is lead jammer for brawling.
Picking up right where she's left off all weekend, an 88 lead percentage here in the playoffs.
Star off the helmet immediately for OJ as lead was awarded to London. She got knocked to the infield, has taken a couple big hits already. Now dealing with Shaolin Scarlet. Here comes Maney to assist in the block. London losing a blocker to the box, but ably holding back Haas with three. Meanwhile, out in front, lead jammer and Dracula works them to the point that they can no longer block, and 5 points go up for London.
And London continuing this seesaw now. They're within two on that jam, 11-9, and that was Katie Black headed to the penalty box for London.
Olivia Shootin'John still has the star in her hand, has not had an opportunity to pass it. And she will not, as it is a penalty now to Peace War, the pivot for Texas. So OJ has no option for a star pass.
Nope, and it looked like we were about to get a call off from Andracula, but perhaps seeing that development, decided to keep this jam going.
OJ does find her way through out of turn four, but here comes Andracula, one to beat up front, gets edged out and calls it off. Compliments of trauma that force out.
She'd already gotten all the points, though. Five more on the board, and now we do have that lead change. So London inching back ahead. 5 minutes in. Expect this kind of back and forth to be going on all game.
It's been going on all day. They took a break in the middle of the day, but seen some great swings.
Yeah, absolutely. Just one real sort of one-sided contest today in the fifth-place game. The rest have been absolute nail-biters. On the Fast Girl Skate start line, it's Master Blaster up against Fifi Nominon for Texas.
3-3 Derby Kid block in the box, as well as Peace War. Up in front, Master Blaster forced out of bounds near the pivot line.
Master Blaster having a great battle with Smarty Pants right now on that outside line.
Ambush with the brace out in front, and a great move around the outside. We do have a lead jammer, Fifi Nominon for the Texecutioners, but watch out because here comes Master Blaster.
Fifi Nominon now 1-for-2 with 50%. This is Master Blaster's first jam of the game for London.
London getting things moving quickly. Oh, running into die, but not getting past is Fifi Nominon. The call off by Texas, a 0-0 jam. Score remains 14-11 in favor of London.
And that's a trend we've been seeing all weekend. This fast pack defense is back, and it has looked great. And I think, again, as we've talked about a little bit, it's a response to this sort of bracing and tight walls that we've been seeing. One way to do that is to keep these packs moving. It keeps things a little bit spread out, makes a lot more room on the track for your skaters. Leading scorer for Texas to the line, Freight Train up against Lexi Lightspeed.
Freight Train right into a pyramid scheme of London. Holding strong, Stephanie Maney, Igwe out there along with Kid Block. Freight Train, all that power, having difficulty. Unusual for Freight Train. Not a lot of teams can do that, but she does persist, gets through, and picks up lead just as she is sent out of bounds.
And that was Stephanie Maney. If there's any blocker in the world who can go up against any jammer in the world, it is Steph Maney, the pivot right now for London Roller Girls.
Slowed up on the outside is Freight Train, then locking back in and pushing against Maney. Maney working her to the line and forcing the track cut. Yes, it is a power jam now. Freight Train headed to the box, and Lexi Lightspeed on a power jam. However, still on the initial pass, and now being recycled from the apex of 1-2 back into the straightaway.
Yeah, Smarty Pants, Jackie Daniels having their way right now with Lexi Lightspeed. Throw CC Boom into that as well.
When Smarty could not finish the block to the inside, Lexi able to get underneath, and Smarty will pick up a forearm penalty in addition. So here comes Lexi on a scoring pass. The offense played up front by Katie Black. Lexi recycled, back 10 feet resets. Now fighting up against Jackie Daniels. America's girlfriend has her and sends her to the infield. He's now going to run her back as Freight Train returns from the penalty box. Instantly resuming that battle with Steph Maney. Kid block helping out.
On a big hit from Jackie Daniels is going to send her to the box, but it did send Lexi Lightspeed to the infield, forcing the Lunder Janet to reset. Neither jammer really making much headway here. Stephanie Maney exits Freight Train.
And a penalty right there. A track cut called on Lexi Lightspeed, so it's going to be a power jam for Texas when we start the next jam. 5 points do go up for London. It's going to make it 19-11 in favor of Brawley.
And interestingly enough, Texas going to take a team timeout here. This team timeout, of course, is sponsored by Rollergirl.ca, Canada's skate shop experience, Canadian customer service at Rollergirl.ca. Talked about Freight Train. You know, she was absolutely untouchable in that first game at 145 points in the first game, had a perfect lead percentage, perfect plus minus and everything, but she did actually run into some trouble last night against Bay Area, only able to put up 33 points in that game.
And they were able to get her into some penalty trouble as well.
Yeah, that was it. And that's what reminded me of that, seeing her go to the penalty box there. It actually dropped her lead percentage all the way down to 69% after last night's game as well. So if they can get Freight Train off her game, that would be a big boon to London as they nurse an 8-point lead right now. It's going to be a power start, as you mentioned, and coming up to the Fast Girl State start line, it will be Haas the Boss.
Haas the Boss assisted out in front by Atrauma, Peace Warrior, and Stoneherd. Jackie Daniels is in the penalty box for the Texecutioners. Meanwhile, for London, Arocha, Jukebox, Olivia Coop, and Dai-Dai. It's
55 versus 55 on the Fast Girl State start line. Haas the Boss all alone.
Mixed up pack out in front of her. Offense coming immediately from Texas. But Haas tries to take the inside. Gets knocked down, recycled back. Running start here. Back into some London blockers. Getting taken down there by Jukebox. Jumps right back up. Now pushing out in front. Great job getting low and getting past Orocha. Just really using the body to throw Orocha off balance and get past.
There was a direction of gameplay penalty due trauma there, and that limits the Texas blockers now on the track. Lexi Lightspeed out of the box. Power jam is over.
Peace Ward jumping up to play a little bit of offense, but then realizing that Lexi Lightspeed was coming back. Drops back to assist with the defense. Quick no pack reforms. Haas the Boss out in front, dealing now with Dai-Dai, who sends her down and out just past the pivot line. That will send Dai-Dai to the box for a forearm. Star pass for London. Jukebox now the jammer. She is free and coming around to score. Meanwhile, Haas the Boss now picking up speed. That is her wheelhouse. Getting an assist there from Jackie Daniels. Gets 5 points for Texas and calls it off, but a good penalty kill there by London.
Absolutely, giving up only 5 points, and that was a very long jam as well. But now Texas within three, 19-16, just coming up to the 10-minute mark here of the first period. Color Falcon plates and Color Q4 boots. Check out all the colorful new goods from Adam Skates. And you can find that at adamskates.com.
And behind the Fast Girl Skates start line, we find two jammers. Fifi Nominon in the white of the Texecutioners. And Rogue Runner number 22 for London in the black and pink. Fifi Nominon making good headway up front, but great recycling as one would expect from Brawling. Working past Maney and picking up lead jammer is Fifi Nominon.
Fifi Nominon now 2-for-2 on the game, or 2-for-3, excuse me, on the game, pulling her lead percentage up to 67 points. Has yet to put any points on the board, though. We'll see if she can do so here.
Kitty Black into the box for London. They now get back Dai-Dai. Rogue Runner still held up. Texas, Jackie Daniels, CeCe Boom, Barbara Ambush, and Smarty Pants on defense, helping Fifi Nominon accrue that jammer lap point, putting up 5.
Star has now been stashed, but she couldn't quite get the pass off. Rogue Runner 0-for-2 and getting handled a little bit here, dropping down to a minus 16 in the plus minus column.
Some great work up on the toe stops by Fifi Nominon, dancing around on the inside line. Another grand slam. Not only have they retaken the lead, they now extend it. 7 points here in favor of the Texecutioners. Here comes Fifi.
Another lean change. Unbelievable start to this game. And Smarty Pants doing a nice job of keeping Stephanie Maney away from the star, although she does now have it in her hand. The star has been and passed. And Stephanie Maney, one of the best jammers who doesn't jam regularly on the planet, has the star.
And she pushes those three Texas blockers up, gets them broken apart, and finally exits the pack. Initial pass completed for Brawling. Steph Maney, new jammer, will not make it around to score points. Three more for Texas. Fifi Namanon, 13-0 jam, makes it 29-19 in favor of the Godmothers of Roller Derby.
That was the highest jam of the game so far. It's been a tight one, and points are hard to come by, but that 13 points, a big boost to Texas right now. Mentioned Stephanie Maney, she's kind of a backup jammer, but an unbelievable backup jammer in backup work this year. She averaged just about 16.9 points per jam. You know, nothing too big. Freight Train going to be jamming for Texas up against Anne Dracula for London.
Out in front, Freight Train is lead jammer just past the pivot line for Texas.
And Freight Train continuing the strong play here, 2-for-2, despite that early penalty. Opportunity now for the first points on the board for Freight Train.
And just bullying through the middle with a 360 to finish it out. 5 points for Texas.
Texas now working well. The star has been stashed.
Stoneher with a big hit, sending Anne Dracula out. She'll lose 10 feet and re-engage with Stoneher and Bittercup.
This is the first bit of adversity that Anne Dracula has really faced all weekend here in the playoffs. She's been virtually untouchable in the opening two games.
Battle up in front. Freight Train taking down. Oh, and drawing a penalty, too. Shaolin Scarlet off to the box, so it'll be Kid Block and Shaolin Scarlet seated for Brawling.
Star pass has now been made once again to Steph Maney. Expect to see her out on the track quite a bit with that pivot stripe on, but Freight Train through calls it off 4-4. Another huge jam, back-to-back massive jams. 14 points on that one, 13 points. It's a 27-0 run for Texas as they open up the biggest lead in the game. 17 minutes to go here in the opening half. On the Fast Girl Skate start line, it's going to be Master Blaster for London, and she will be lining up against Olivia Shootin' John. Olivia Shootin' John 0-2 and minus 10 in the plus-minus column.
4-2 pack advantage for Texas. Oh, back block on Olivia Shootin' John means it's a power jam here for Brawling. They do have the blocker deficit, though. It's starting to even out, though, because Barbara Ambush is off to the box for a multiplayer block.
Jukebox, the lone jammer, a blocker right now working offense for her jammer, and does do so successfully.
CC Boom now off to the box to join Barbara Ambush. So it was 2-3, now 3-2 in favor of London, who is on a power jam. Here comes the sweep. Great job on the offense from London, but answering back is Texas. And Master Blaster sent to the infield will reset.
And when you only got two blockers on the track, you might as well have Jackie Daniels and Smarty Pants doing fine work here, but Smarty Pants picking up a cutting penalty.
Olivia Shootin' John out of the box, eyes on Master Blaster. Master Blaster with lead now overtakes OJ. Clear outside path for Master Blaster, 4 points for London.
This is a huge response for London now after giving up that 27 points and two jams. Master Blaster bringing London back into this game.
Texas back up to three blockers, soon up to four as Smarty Pants is standing. Both teams battling in turn four. Resetting Master Blaster. Approaching, but great recycling. Good movement from Texas. Nearly open inside line there for Olivia Shootin' John. But again, cycling back up is London. Both these teams call and answer.
Great defense here. When we have full packs, there is not much room to work with. Jukebox looking to work some offense, but jammer now trapped on the inside line.
Olivia Shootin' John pushing patiently, waiting for offensive assistance. It comes in the form of a wrecking ball named CC Boom. However, London so good about getting their steps back in front of that offensive blocker. Boom now takes Jukebox out of the equation. Juke going to come back and play offense. Those final two blockers do keep Texas hemmed in, and that jam will end. No points for the Texecutioners, and 13 for London. 43-32 our score. 15 minutes and 37 seconds gone in this first half.
You are watching Championship Derby here on WFTDA.tv, our first Division I final of the 2016 season. And we'd like to thank Fast Girl Skates, who are very proud to sponsor the 2016 WFTDA Tournament MVPs. Remember to stick around after this game to find out who's going to take that hardware home from Montreal.
Could it be one of these jammers, Fifi Namanon or Lexi Lightspeed, for their respective squads? 5-on-5 roller derby. means a 4-on-1 jammer for the most part.
Yes. Nice little knockout by Trauma there, and drag back by She and Stone Her, working well together.
Fifi Namanon taking hits on her way to the front. Now the last two London blockers to beat. She does lead jammer for Fifi Namanon and the Texecutioners.
So Texecutioners swinging right back after giving up that 13-0 jam. And Fifi Namanon now 3-for-4 with lead jammer status and 13 points.
Takes a hit there from Shaolin Scarlet. Then pushes up, has Kid Block the last line of defense for London. The back goes up, Kid Block releases, and 5 points go up for Fifi Namanon.
Nice job by Lexi Lightspeed to absorb a couple blows, but stay in bounds and complete her initial pass.
Jukebox being goaded right now by Texas, and that frees Fifi Namanon up to the front. Quick 4 points for the Texecutioners, and a 9-point jam makes it 52-32 in favor of Texas. 12:51 left in the first.
So both these teams now swinging big. We've got some big jams in the last few. I'd like to take an opportunity, though, to thank some of our sponsors here. S1 Helmets. Did you know that in addition to helmets, S1 now makes pads for roller derby too? Make S1 part of your uniform. Who knew?
Somebody did, because the copy came from somewhere. Rogue Runner jamming for London, and she'll be facing off against Haas the Boss for Texas.
Haas direction, the Boss. Oh, sitting on 16 of, points right now.
Direction of gameplay penalty to Jukebox. This is the short trip to the box. And now Haas the Boss rolling off London blockers one after the other. Dodges a hit out in front and picks up lead jammer for Texas.
And Rogue Runner now remaining the sole London jammer to not pick up lead jammer status yet. So Texas has Rogue Runner's number.
Star comes off, and then Rogue goes down on the hip of Barbara Ambush. Ambush now, oh, tries to push her to the infield, but the body position advantage belonged to Rogue Runner, and she is free, and she's going to have a power jam now because we have a cut on Haas the Boss. Here comes Rogue. Good speed, hits Jackie Daniels, bounces off, and then gets back up. Jackie there in front of her. Now dealing with Smarty Pants. Going to reset and look for a better opportunity.
Rogue Runner now putting points on the board despite not getting lead jammer status yet. She is sitting on a few. Just a matter of how many.
Offense coming from London to take out Barbara Ambush, but there waiting for Rogue was Jackie Daniels, along with Smarty.
Those guys working so well together, the two veterans.
Forearm call will thin out the Texas pack.
And that ends the power jam, so great defense there from Texas. Haas the Boss freed, and we have 30 seconds left now to work with.
Arocha and Smarty Pants in the box for their respective teams. Haas the Boss trying to score points, but being held back right now. Great job by Jukebox. Haas finding some room, but London there to greet her. Out in front again. Jukebox and Die Die working Haas to the edge. Nearly gets around, gets her feet around, then almost around on the inside, but knocked to the infield. Meanwhile, Rogue Runner having difficulties of her own in the back, dealing with Jackie Daniels. It'll be 5 points. For London, 2 points. I'm sorry, 5 points for Texas, 2 points, 3 points for London. They changed that on me.
So that's going to
regardless,
make
at the end of the jam, it's 8 for London, 5 for Texas. That makes it 57-40 in favor of the Texecutioners. Just over 10 left in the first.
That's right, and we'd like to take this opportunity to give a big shout-out to Radar Wheels. Thank you for supporting this WFTDA tournament, as you have done so much. Radar Wheels, part of the Rydell family.
Freight train for Texas. And Dracula for London. Texas starting their entire blocking core up on the pivot line. And Kid Block there for London to make noise. Tries pushing in, but a good job by Stone Her to absorb the block. Meanwhile, in the back, Freight Train with the slow push. Finds room on the inside, steps over, one to beat, and she does. Lead jammer after blasting past Kid Block. It's Freight Train.
Freight Train keeps that 100% lead percentage going now and looking to work on the 14 points she's already put up in this game.
Stash for Andracula. She exits the pack. And on the other side of the track, it's a cut for Freight Train. So a power jam here for Andracula and Brawling.
This is Freight Train's second penalty of the game so far. Here in the late stages of the first half. Full packs out there on the defense and the offense for this power jam.
Texas swarming to the front. You got to be careful about the no pack. They're getting the warning right now. They'll drop Peace War, but Stoneher will relent as well. And Andracula snags a fistful of points for London. Power jam rolling on.
Texas lucky to be in the lead still. They've given up four power jams now to London's one.
Bittercup being goaded, knocked out, now hangs back so her team can engage up front. And engage they do, Trauma forcing Andracula to the infield. Andracula going to lose 40 feet and reset back behind that Fast Girl Skate start line. Goes right into a brace two wall. And well, out in front, same thing happening for Freight Train, pushing up against London.
Maney, Scarlett, and Kid Block working nicely, but Freight Train finally able to power them out of play and gets through on a scoring pass. Four on the board for Texas.
Instantly, London responds by playing offense. Nearly taken out by Peace War was Andracula, but right there was Shaolin Scarlett to take her down. Freight Train back up into the mix right at the end of that jam. Two more points for Texas. They'll make it 10-6 in favor of London on that jam. Texas still with a 13-point lead, 7:50 left in the first half and counting down.
Interesting development here, AK. We've yet to see Bloody Mary jam in this game, and she, of course, is having a fantastic weekend and now finally getting an opportunity with the star as she rolls out to the Fast Girl Skate start line, standing next to number two, Master Blaster, in the black for London.
Both packs out by the pivot line. Bloody Mary coming in hot, taking down Jukebox. Now moving perpendicular to the track. Not finding room on the inside, spinning around and looking for room on the out. Through on the inside is Master Blaster, but she gets overtaken by Bloody Mary. Bloody Mary now pulling away from Master Blaster.
Ballistic whistle, though, the bench coach for London telling Master Blaster to keep this one going. There's
Bloody Mary slipping on the sport cart. We've heard all weekend that it has been slick in the turns.
And it is getting hot in here right now tonight. This is a packed house, and you can feel the heat emanating up from the floorboards here at the Centre Pierre Charbonneau.
No pack called, and CC Boom drops back, but the rest of the Texas blockers hold strong against Master Blaster. Meanwhile, Bloody Mary working against the blocking sled that is the London defense. Gets taken down there by Jukebox, jumps back up.
Unbelievable defense from both teams here on this jam, and this is what we've been seeing when those penalty boxes are empty. It is hard to make any sort of motion whatsoever. Finally, a multiplayer block penalty will open up some of the track. It's Arocha heading to the penalty box for London.
All this pushing, they've made it from the pivot line into the apex between one and two. We have another penalty coming, a direction of gameplay. We'll send Barbara Ambush to the box. Now only three defenders to deal with Master Blaster.
And Jackie Daniels forced to bridge now, so there's only two at the front of that pack for Master Blaster.
Meanwhile in the back, Bloody Mary still pushing against London. Hand goes up and signals. The pivot out front, Jackie Daniels is the bridge right now. Master Blaster out, no pass, no penalty, and 4 points for London.
London inching closer now within 9 points. Master Blaster will not have enough time, though, to get around on another scoring pass. Four on the board, though, for Bloody Mary. So it's a 13-point game as we near the five-minute mark here of the opening half. And roll faster, farther, and smoother with precision bearings from Quick. Quick, part of the Rydell family. Well, what a game we've had here so far.
Yes,
AK
indeed, Derby
living
Nerd.
Up to the billing. 13-point difference between these two world-class flat track roller derby teams. It's going to be a 4-3 pack advantage here for London. It's going to be Fifi Nominon squaring off against Lexi Lightspeed.
That's right, Barbara Ambush in the box still for Texas. Spinning back and forth is Lexi Lightspeed, but spinning as well is the Texas defensive triangle. They get her out of bounds. Running her back now is Stoneher. Just missing the cut there was Lexi Lightspeed. Oh, yes, and it is going to be sending. Yep, was caught. I thought, no, it's going to be a cut on the Texas pivot. Yes. So, lead jammer does belong to Lexi Lightspeed. Fifi Nominon, however, has overtaken her on the floor. Texas out in front.
We saw this in the last jam, too. London, despite getting past, deciding to keep it going, and Lexi Lightspeed almost made it through. But not quite. Stone her with the exit hit.
She gets dragged back to the start line. Up front, Fifi Nominon dealing with a brace two wall. As Maney, the bridge, potentially offensive blocker, is going to jump into the fray and help out Lexi Lightspeed. Nice response, however, by Texas. Peace War, eyes on the jammer. Trauma out of the box now, and Texas back up to full strength.
Unbelievable defense continuing here on this long jam, and we've had a bunch of jams go long and even to the full two. Barbara Ambush now providing the bridge.
She jumped up to play offense as soon as Peace War got back in on the defensive end of things, but now Ambush going to come back and play defense as Igwe spotted as a potential jammer assister.
Lexi Lightspeed doing a nice job of stopping her momentum from going back onto the track. Very close to a cut track call there. 4-4 was the jam. 71-58 now. 2 minutes to go, or 3 minutes to go, excuse me, here in the opening half. And we have had two jams back-to-back go 4-4, so there's been no movement on that scoreboard, at least in terms of the differential between these two teams.
Yeah, very little movement on the floor, just the hard grind against those defensive formations. Both these teams so proficient at it, not only holding it, but shifting it appropriately.
Yeah, it's been wonderful to watch the transitions as well.
But a wide-open line on the outside for Rogue Runner lead jammer London Brawling.
That is Rogue Runner's first lead jammer of the game. She did pick up 8 points despite not getting lead on her last jam, though.
She seems to be heating up, though. Great movement, good speed, full head of steam through the pack, and that's going to be a grand slam for London Brawling.
Huge burst of speed for Rogue Runner London, getting closer now within 8 points.
Haas the boss, not to be outdone on the speed front, turning on her afterburners. Rogue bumped out into turn four. She takes the floor and will call it off from the infield. No points on the second scoring pass for her, but 5 on the first. None for Texas.
And just to take a quick look here at the stats, scoring is spread out on both teams, but Ann Dracula is, as she has all weekend, leading the way a little bit for London. 26 points on the board for Fifi Nominan leads the way in that regard. And on the fast girl skate start line for this jam, when it does get underway, we are going to see the aforementioned Ann Dracula sitting with 20 points on 25% lead percentage, and Freight Train for Texas.
Some discussion coming from Ballistic Whistle, who will spend this jam from the infield as it starts. Freight Train pushing, working past Steph Maney. Kid block there to stop her. Now help coming from the rest of the pack. Meanwhile, in the back, and Dracula locked up. Oh, we've got a penalty. It is a track cut on Freight Train. That is her third trip to the box already here in the first half, and it's a power jam for Brawling.
And now London also going to be looking for their fourth straight lead jammer status if they can get their jammer through on this power jam. And they've got a great opportunity to do so, and they do. That's the fourth straight lead jam for London.
Goading Stoneher in the back. London providing offense that way. A little different way to approach it, but successful as well. And Dracula coming on a scoring pass. Jumping up, being taken down right there. Great job by Bittercup for the Texecutioners.
Shaolin Scarlet, our jukebox, trying to work some offense. Or sorry, that's Steph Maney.
Yes.
I was going to get there eventually. Freight Train coming out of the penalty box and approaching the pack now, which is dead stopped at turn three.
They do work And Dracula out of bounds at the turn. Texas going to lose Stoneher to the box. And Dracula, last line of defense is a Peace War. Peace War has been everywhere this tournament. Right now, she gets to the one place you don't want to be. That's out of play, so she lets And Dracula go, and that's 5 points for Brawling.
Great effort, though, from Peace War, just holding for as long as she could, trying to buy Freight Train some time. Unfortunately, though, Freight Train knocked out and dragged back to the backstretch.
Here comes Freight Train again on the approach. London there to meet her. Three defenders. Offense being played by Shaolin Scarlet, but that leaves an open inside line for Freight Train to get through and finish her initial pass.
We do have an opportunity here for a potential lead change if Ann Dracula can get a full scoring pass. She's only got two, so that means they're going to be within 1 point, and that leads us into halftime. Oh my, another heck of a game here in Montreal at the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs. AK, I'm breathless.
Let's take a minute. We still have 30 more minutes of this amazing play. Why don't we just recap
yeah.
and that will help us center ourselves.
Yes, thank you. Well, it's been an unbelievable game. One thing I think that's been fascinating is that Texas Rollergirls have run into some serious jammer penalty problems.
Yeah.
Five jammer penalties given up to just one for London. But yeah, you look at the scoreboard, and Texas has remained ahead for a vast majority of that opening half. So phenomenal penalty killing from the Texas Rollergirls packs.
That's right. Points being scored by London and Dracula leads with 27, 17 for Master Blaster and 13 aside for Rogue Runner and Lexi Lightspeed. And how about Texas?
Yeah, and over on Texas, scoring also spread out quite nicely. Fifi Nominon sitting on 26 points, followed by Freight Train with 20 and Haas the Boss with 21. Bloody Mary has only 4 points, but she's done so on her single jam. And Olivia Shootin' John yet to crack the scoreboard in her two jams.
All right, only a couple players with three penalties, Barbara Ambush, Freight Train, and Smarty Pants for Texas. And on the other side, Kid Block, the only skater with three. You got a couple with two, some with none, and a lot with none. So that's the breakdown on the first half. We encourage you to center yourself and stay tuned here to WFTDA.TV for the second half of this championship game from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. He is the Derby Nerd. I'm AK 40 Ounce, and we will be back with you in just a few. Welcome back from Le Centre Pierre Charbonneau in Montreal, Quebec, Canada, here for the 2016 International Division 1 playoffs. I'm AK 40 Ounce, this is the Derby Nerd, and we have 30 more minutes of roller derby left.
Thank goodness that we do have more, because that first half was just not quite enough. An amazing opening half here in the championship game, a one-point game, and there really isn't much separating these two teams on the track.
No, some numbers do separate them ever so slightly, however, besides that 1 point on the scoreboard in favor of Texas.
Yeah, absolutely. Texas does have more leads, 9 to 7 for London, but Texas has lost three leads to penalties. London has yet to lose any. So we could take a look at it. It's maybe 7-6 in favor of London. But again, the numbers, when you look at it and break it down, all come out kind of even.
That's right. And looking at jammer penalties, the one thing that is a bit uneven are the jammer penalties for Texas. 5 trips to the box, including those 3 loss leads. Only 1 for London.
Yeah, absolutely. And but Texas doing a great job of killing those penalties and not giving up too much. And when you look at blocker penalties, it's 13-12. So again, nothing separating them on the track in that regard either.
So as we are about to write history, you can read some history. Pick up this book right here, 8-Wheeled Freedom from Dave Miller. You can find it at fine bookstores and even the ones that are not so good, but it's also available online if you don't like going to the bookstore.
But you should, because bookstores are great.
They are. You know what else is great? This game, 71-70 in favor of Texas through 30 minutes.
Yeah, and some other interesting things to note. Both teams have 2 double-digit jams in that half. At jam number 7 and 8, Texas was looking to pull ahead. They had a 13 and then a 14-point jam, but London came roaring right back with a 13-pointer of their own, followed 3 jams later with a 10-pointer to narrow that gap once again. But really, no team has gone on too big of a run so far in this game.
Yeah, and a small run right at the end of the first half, 12-0 in favor of London, brought it from 71-58 to 71-70. They do still have the lead, but by the slightest of margins.
Yeah, and London, as part of that run, did pick up the last 4 lead jammer statuses of the half. The first two, though, didn't equate to anything. They were 4-4 jams, and then they did get those 12, as you mentioned, on the final 2.
So, of course, we know which teams are going to champs out of this weekend. Montreal in third place. First and second still up for debate. One of these teams will get a bye, a trophy, and gold medals. The other team, silver medals, but they still get to go and show their chops in Portland.
Absolutely, and do stick around after this game. We'll have a brief break and then come back with the medal ceremonies. And, let's hear what are your opinions. Who should win the MVP, for example? Talk to WFTDA on Twitter. Tell us who you think. I saw we see that Freight Train's being thrown around as an option. Miracle Whips from Montreal. Peace War, who has been unbelievable in the pack for Texas. Let us know. Who do you think?
There have been standouts from every team. We want to hear your thoughts right now. 2 standout players in the spectrum of all of roller derby. We've got Fifi Nominon for Texas pushing up against a braced 2-wall of London blockers, and Lexi Lightspeed in the back dealing with Smarty Pants. And now Ambush finding room, but then finds Smarty Pants.
And Ambush heads to the penalty box. First penalty here the second half. Slight pack advantage for London, and they use that to get lead jammer status.
Yeah, working just past CC Boom was Lexi Lightspeed. Texas needs to get Fifi Nominon out, but she is being slowed up. Great job out there by Stephanie Maney.
Lexi Lightspeed now on a 50% lead percentage and looking to add to 13 points. She's already scored.
Works from outside to in and picks up five. That means London takes the lead now, 75-71. Here comes Lexi on another scoring pass. Meanwhile, Fifi Nominon dragged back, star in hand.
The pivot is Jackie Daniels if a star pass is necessary here.
Jackie, however, eyes on the jammer for London. Now she's working around, finds Jackie again on the inside. Bumped to the outside by Jackie Smarty Pants and finished off by Barbara Ambush. Hands to the hips for Lexi. That 1-2-3 punch will close out the jam. But another 5 points for London. 10-point jam to open up the second half. 80-71 is our score in favor of Brawling.
And another lead change here. So London continuing where they left off. And they've been on a bit of a run here now. 22-0 run stretching over from the end of the first half. And on the fast girl skate start line, it's going to be Rogue Runner for London up against Haas the Boss for Texas.
Texas moving back just before the start whistle to take a three wall with potential brace. No bracing, just flipping and blocking for Bitter Cup. Texas then recycling back up to the front. Good job by Rogue Runner to pick up speed and get physical. Pushing through, goes down right there, but springs right back up. One-on-one with Peace War in front. Peace War is going to have some help from her friends. Then have to go one-on-one again. And while in the back, jumping around, not finding room is Haas the Boss.
And Peace War with a big hit, but couldn't quite push Rogue Runner out of bounds. And Rogue Runner through picks up lead jammer status after 30 seconds of battle.
Haas the Boss run back reset, now getting lapped. Bumped into the infield, however, is Rogue Runner. Rogue resetting and cut the track in doing so. So it's going to be a power jam for Haas the Boss as Rogue Runner headed off to the box on a track cut.
So first power jam here of the second half going to Texas's favor just as London had pulled ahead. Texas now with an opportunity to narrow the gap or even tie it up.
Passive offense from Texas pays off and Haas the Boss is through on an initial pass.
Texas did have a blocker trapped back there. And they still have that blocker trapped, so the pack has not moved. And Haas the Boss very quickly coming around on her scoring pass.
Haas finding Jukebox on the outside, so offense clears her. Offense now coming from Peace War on the inside to help get Haas up. But a great job recycling all game, all tournament, all career by Jukebox and Die-Die. Die-Die almost getting Haas to the edge, but Haas will hop through on the outside line for a five-pointer.
So great penalty kill, only 5 points given up as the jammer penalty has now ended. Rogue Runner back on the track, but very quickly knocked out by Peace War and a pop back. Gets the call on Rogue Runner right back into the penalty box.
That was Bitter Cup with that jump back penalty cut draw. Right now, Haas the Boss dealing with Jukebox, trying to roll off or just going to send her to the floor. A little easier to pass when she can't stand up. One-on-one with Die-Die, 5 points are scored by Haas the Boss. So after some difficulty early in the jam, 10 points for number 55. It brings it to within two. 83-81 in favor of London. 4 minutes gone in the second. Nerd.
And Stonehur had picked up a penalty at the end of that jam. So it will be a power start for Texas, but they'll be down a blocker. All four defenders out on the track, led by pivot Stephanie Maney, Arocha, Kid Block, and Katie Black. Going to work this penalty kill on the power start. And Fifi Nominon jamming for the Texas Roller Girls.
Start out at the pivot line, quickly moving, and Fifi Nominon speeds up. But London, even though they're faster, so good at getting back together. They've got it locked down. They're getting broken apart right now. Fifi Nominon spun into the infield, but does accrue lead jammer status for Texas. Power jam over, Rogue Runner back on the track.
Nice work by Stephanie Maney and the London Roller Girls to kill off that potentially devastating power start. And they did buy enough time for Rogue Runner to get back out there. And now she's working her way through that pack.
Rogue Runner free and clear of her initial pass. And no points right there for Fifi Nominon. So a lot of credit to the London defense holding her up. 0-0 jam. Score remains 83-81. London with the lead.
And Smarty Pants is in the box, so Texas will be pivotless to kick off this next jam.
That's four for Smarty Pants. Also sitting on four, Barbara Ambush for Texas.
Performance plates for the modern derby game, Power Dine, a part of the Rydell family. On the Fast Girl Skate start line, it's going to be Anne Dracula for London and up against Bloody Mary in her second jam of this game for Texas.
Sparsely used early in this game, Bloody Mary successful in her first one. Now making headway, but out in front of her, Die Die keeping ahead. Rolling around the outside is Bloody Mary. Just past Die Die, but another London defender to hold her up, and lead jammer goes to Anne Dracula, but Bloody Mary out just behind her.
Smarty Pants out of the penalty box, and now Peace War right back in it. She will be followed, though, by Die Die, so it will be all even on the track, 3-3.
Quick 2 points picked up as Bittercup had been sent to the floor. Anne Dracula cruises past her, gets the point for her and Peace War in the box, and calls it off, extending their lead now 4 points in favor of the one seed.
And Fast Girl Skates, we know we've been talking about them all day, but they've been 9 years to making a faster you as a skater. Big thanks for all the support to FastGirlSkates.com.
5 seconds to call from our jam timer, Wizard of Laws, and the hand comes down with the whistle. It is Haas the Boss for Texas, Master Blaster for London. Master Blaster, no room on the inside, held up by Smarty Pants, and Haas the Boss is your lead jammer.
Been a bit of a quiet game comparatively for Master Blaster, only 17 points so far.
Master Blaster still held up in the back, and Haas the Boss, oh, just one blocker out there, able to knock Haas out and back.
Stephanie Maney with that unbelievable hit out. I'm surprised we haven't heard much more chatter for her as potential MVP in this tournament.
Oh, it's out there, I'm sure. Still holding strong. Offense coming from Texas. Unsuccessful. Peace War gets aggressive but goes down. Jackie Daniels now off to the box for a forearm, meaning only two left out in front. See, boom. Facing, dealing with, holding back Master Blaster. Texas jumping up. Peace War now, along with CC Boom. Meanwhile, in the back, Haas the Boss sent down to the infield, just past the start line, dragged back by Maney.
Great back defense here at the front of the pack from Peace War. And was that Barbara Ambush or CC Boom? I believe it was CC Boom,
yes,
who's knocked to the infield.
Master Blaster face-to-face with Peace War. Now Smarty Pants gets into the mix. Smarty Pants pushing Master Blaster towards the infield. She stays in bounds, however, and finishes her initial pass.
Jackie Daniels out of the penalty box and opens up a lane for Haas the Boss. She was twirling, falling, did put 5 points up on the board. And we've got yet another lead change. Texas now pulling ahead 86 to 85, 8 minutes here into the second half. This game continues to seesaw back and forth. Unbelievable. You should check out the new pilot plate in 7 stunning colors from AdamSkates.com. And it looks like we're going to have a timeout, and this timeout will be sponsored by Rollergirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. You can experience the Canadian dollar and great Canadian customer service as well.
This is the second timeout for the Texecutioners. They do have their official review left in this second half, and we'll have one timeout remaining on the board with 21:54 left. It gives them limited options for time management towards the end.
It does, and London still has a full set of timeouts, all three in their official review as well, so we'll see if that has any effect on the late stages of this game. And we have seen this weekend some situations. Sun State in their opening game, of course, blew through their timeouts a little too early and then ended up losing a fairly close game and no opportunities to slow the clock at the end. So it certainly is a factor, and we'll see if it becomes one in this game. Fifi Nominon on the Fast Girl Skate start line for Texas, and she is facing off against Lexi Lightspeed. 4-2 pack advantage for Texas.
Lexi Lightspeed, however, stepping just past the trauma and picks up lead jammer for London. Coming through, though, Fifi Nominon, one to beat, slowed up, not finding any luck past jukebox. Now she does, and she is through. Lexi Lightspeed spun out and then bumped out, finished by trauma in turn one. Here comes Fifi Nominon.
Wow.
They're letting this roll out to kill that penalty time. Fifi Nominon going for the jump on the inside, but gets taken down by Die Die and dragged back.
Trauma being called off with a back-blocking penalty, and she is being followed by Stoneher.
Or it's Dolores Fuentes.
Oh, it is Dolores Fuentes. Thank you for that correction, AK. Jam comes to a conclusion. No more points, 4-4 on the jam, so the 1 point gap remains.
Remember, folks, if you are just listening to us, you can still tune in. Get the live feed, the high-quality video. It's still a value for not only this game, because you know what? If you're a fan of Derby, if you're a Derby skater, you have to watch the top teams to learn things.
Treble 909 on Twitter says Peace War is 100% war and 0% peace tonight. Absolutely. Hashtag talk to WFTDA.
Oh, Texas now with some difficulty as Barbara Ambush is sent to the box. They've only got one blocker out there. And that Smarty Pants lead jammer has been awarded to Roadrunner. Here she comes. Speeds pass, but then just gets sent out. Haas the boss. Playing some defense as well against Roadrunner.
Just trying to buy some time, and Barbara Ambush now back on the track as well as she's waiting for a spot opening in the penalty box, which it has.
Jailbreak for Texas. They get back Trauma and Fuertes.
Haas has removed the star, and Trauma is up there in that London pack with her.
Lead and scoring. Roadrunner bowling over Smarty Pants and finding a wide open outside lane for a second 5-point scoring pass. 10-0 jam for London so far.
They have retaken the lead. Roadrunner, who had a slow start to this game, has just been on fire in her last few jams, now working her way up to 26 points and will now become London's leading scorer with an additional 5. So 31 points now on the board for Roadrunner.
Dancing back and forth, Roadrunner on that last pass. Here she comes on another scoring pass. Texas, only two blockers. Ably jumped by the London jammer. Roadrunner, 5 more points, 20-point jam.
Haas, the boss, being owned in this jam, and that is not something we are used to seeing. Unbelievable work here from the London Roller Girls as they have taken control of this game with a massive jam, the biggest one so far we've seen tonight.
High block means that London is going to lose Maney to the box, but you know what? Roadrunner making up for it. 4 more points. Big jam here. 4 points answered back.
Trauma now with the star on the star pass goes spinning through that pack for points of her own. And she's going to steal a few more.
Stepping around on the outside. 4 more points for London. 2 more points for Texas. 7 for the Cushioners. 97 is their score. 33-point jam. Breaks things open for London. They have 122. We have 18:27 left in this game.
Yes, and what a great performance there. London went into that jam down, and now they come out with a big lead. And this next jam is already underway. Freight Train versus Anne Dracula, and we've got a 4-3 pack advantage for Texas.
Freight Train chugging along. Lead jammer. Jukebox overcommitted on the block and took her own defensive player out. Moved Orocha out of the way for Freight. Here comes Train. Chugging along, gets hit right there and slowed up by Dai Dai. Now fighting against number 77. Meanwhile,
Stephanie Maney comes out of the penalty box and immediately starts working the offense.
Yep. Grand slam here for Freight Train, and Maney gets the star, is now the jammer for London. Texas going to lose a blocker to the box. 4-3 pack advantage for London as Freight Train comes again. Freight Train spinning hips forward will get 1 point for Texas. Make it a 6-0 jam in favor of the Texecutioners. They trail now by 19.
S1 Pro Knee Pad stability, function, durability, and superior shock absorption makes the S1 Pro Knee Pad built for roller derby. Find out more at s1helmets.com. And while we're at it, let's also make your skates your own with custom-colored, handcrafted Color Lab boots by Rydell Skates. Find out more at rydellskates.com.
So Texas still with Peace War in the penalty box, coming out with Fifi Namanon. She will be opposed by Master Blaster and a full pack of London blockers. Stephanie Maney, Kid Block, Helvetica Black, and Shaolin Scarlet.
Peace War remains in the penalty box.
Being sent out in the turn, Helvetica Black against Fifi Namanon, who's going to reset just before turn one. Meanwhile, out in front, offensive help coming from Kid Block, but Texas doing a good job. Master Blaster stepping over lead jammer, London Brawling.
Took 35 seconds and about 3/4 of a lap, but Master Blaster is through now. Lead jammer status for London.
Star is in hand of Fifi Namanon. Jackie Daniels the pivot, keeping an eye on things, but also making sure that Master Blaster is held up. Master Blaster looking for him on the outside.
As you can see, Peace War back on the track now, holding that outside line that Stephanie Mania is trying to open up. But nice reset from the Texas defense.
Maney, a couple different approaches to offensive blocking, but Texas responding, readjusting their form. Out in front, they're now a braced two-wall at the Fast Girls start line. Meanwhile, back in turn four, London dealing with Fifi Nominon. CC Boom backwards on Master Blaster. We had a star pass now to Jackie Daniels. Fifi Nominon playing defense as Jackie Daniels finding room on the outside. She is through. New jammer for Texas is done with her initial pass, but won't get back around as the jam is called. 5 points for Master Blaster.
Master Blaster able to get all five, and that pulls her up now to 22 points on the game. She's sitting on a 60% lead percentage. So a continued impressive performance here from the first-year jammer for London, formerly of Bear City. And on the fast girl skate starting line, it's going to be Lexi Lightspeed sitting on 27 points so far for this game. Going to be facing off against Haas, the boss, who has 43 of her own to lead the Texas Roller Girls.
Braced two-wall for London and an offensive floater. Braced three-wall up front for Texas. Lexi jumping up, cracking it apart, but then it quickly reforms. Holding strong is Fuertes. Now getting the shoulder on her. Finishing block. Coming from Bloody Mary, who's now cat and mouse with Lexi. Lexi in clean, but still dealing now with Stoneher. Sorry, that was Stoneher.
Yep, and Stoneher did draw that track cut on the jammer, so it's going to be a power jam opportunity here for Texas, just as this game was seeming to get a little bit of away from them. An opportunity now to narrow that gap.
Orocha out of the box, springing back into action past Stoneher. Stoneher now jumping up to play offense. Haas the boss, taking a hit, rolling off jukebox. But London right there. Texas on the power jam. Haas has had some trouble. They have no option on the pivot because Trauma is in the box. Haas getting run back to the apex.
Three jams this half so far for Haas the boss. She was able to pick up lead jammer on just one of them. Excuse me, that's one for four so far this jam. So yes, London making some nice adjustments on the Haas the boss. Coming out of the penalty box, so the power jam is over. Lexi Lightspeed getting low and approaching a three wall of Texas blockers.
She gets bumped out by Trauma and then comes back to reset. Offense now coming. Olivia Coop not having any luck. Direction of gameplay penalty will thin things out for Texas. Stonehurst is coming back.
That is Dolores Fuertes heading to the penalty box for the Texecutioners.
Lead jammer goes to Haas, the boss, a minute and 40 into this jam. She does get passed on the floor, but no points either side. 0-0 jam. Her score remains 127-103 in favor of London Brawling.
And the grind continues here. 13 minutes left in the championship game, and it is getting pretty brutal on that track. As you mentioned, a minute and 40 seconds before lead jammer status was confirmed. So unbelievable defense from these two teams. It's going to be one in the box for Texas. Fuertes remains. It's going to be a 4-3 pack advantage for London. And on the fast girl skate start line, it is Rogue Runner, who's been having a heck of a second half here for London. And she'll be facing off against the veteran Bloody Mary for Texas.
Bloody Mary slowly rolling her back to get that running start. And a running start benefits Rogue Runner. Lead jammer, meet me for London Brawling.
And Bloody Mary now 0 for 4 in her limited time on the track. And she's got the star stashed in her hand. Jackie Daniels is the Texas pivot on the track.
Great fake by Rogue right there. Got CC Boom moving out of that wall, and then the shoulder breaking things up. Still pushing up front.
Rogue Runner was exited, had to reset at turn number three.
Pushing up front, Texas not able to break free.
Tried to sneak by Smarty Pants on the inside. Smarty Pants was having none of that.
Now locked up. All four Texas defenders in a cube formation, making sure they're not out of play.
That's Kid Block providing the link between the two split packs. Unbelievable defense continuing here, but London slowly being peeled off.
Yeah, it's Igwe backwards dealing with Bloody Mary, but patient, calculated, cold-blooded Bloody Mary. Star back on the helmet and coming around to the scoring pass. 5 points. Do get awarded to London as that one is called off before Bloody can get back around. 5-0 jam extends the lead. Now 132 for London, 103 for Texas. 11-10 counting down in the second half.
three straight jams now without a point on the board for Texas, and that it does account for this increased London lead. Slowly, London able to take control of this game and kind of keeping a step ahead of Texas here in the second half after a nail-bitingly close first.
29 points in favor of Brawling. They go to Andracula with the star. Freight Train jamming for Texas. Andracula, good jumping movements, taking hits, but staying up on her toes. Being worked to the edges, but not getting close enough to be dangerous. Meanwhile, Freight Train in the back pushing against a brace two wall of Brawling.
And again, we're seeing that when these are full packs on the track, there is not much room for jammers to move, to make a movement. And a nice, though patient, move from Andracula, just waiting out the Texas defense lead jammer, London Brawling.
Andracula coming back around, all four executioners on defense waiting for her. They do have her locked up. Meanwhile, out in front, Freight Train is through. Initial pass complete for Freight. Stoneher going to the box. Freight Train back around almost in time, but not quite. Two more points for London. 134 for them, 103 for Texas. Under 10 minutes remain. I am AK 40 Ounce. He is the Derby Nerd. This is WFTDA.TV, the gold medal game from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, Division One playoffs.
And what a weekend it has been. A big thank you to Montreal Roller Derby for putting on an absolutely unbelievable division playoff. And I'm not just saying that because I'm Canadian.
Right.
It truly has been one of the better division playoffs I've ever been to in the WFTDA tournament history, my history with
yes.
the tournaments. We've had full crowds all weekend, amazing halftime shows. I hope you get to catch a little bit of this one. We had some retired Montreal skaters leading a dance party in the center of the track, as only Montreal can do.
Derby Nerd, we are in a team timeout for mm-hmm. Texas. This team timeout, of course, all of our team timeouts throughout the weekend brought to us by
Fast Girl Skates. No, by Rollergirl.ca.
Yes.
Oh, it's getting late in the tournament.
It is. It has been a grind, not only for these skaters, but for all of us. As I have a feeling this is going to be an exciting finish right now. 31-point difference in favor of London. I'd like to send a shout-out again to Montreal for hosting. They've done a great job all around. Thanks, of course, to our tournament head announcer, Mr. Whistler, for organizing everything.
Yes, our head announcer, our captain, my captain, for the weekend. It's going to be a 4-3 pack advantage here to kick things off. Coming out of the timeout, that was Texas's last team timeout as well. They do have one OR remaining here for the remainder of this game.
Stoneher in the box for Texas. Fifi Namina now pushing, working against braced two wall of London. Pyramid scheme holds strong. Jukebox on the outside.
It's been two leads in a row now for London. So Texas, to get back in this, would love to pick up a lead jammer status here.
Fifi Namina taking down Shaolin Scarlet, jumping right back up and met by a multiplayer block, which is going to peel off Helvetica Black. Offense now coming from Stoneher, working back and forth. And Fifi Namina is through, lead jammer Texas. But watch out, because here comes Master Blaster. Only a quarter track behind. Fifi Namanon, good speed coming back around. Master Blaster hot on her heels. One past 2 points accrued, and a call off from Fifi Namanon make it 105 for Texas, 134 for London.
But boy, Texas really needed that points. They had gone four jams without putting anything on the board. So starting now to chip away a little bit at the lead. They're going to have a pack advantage here to kick off this next jam as Katie Black remains in the penalty box. And on the Fast Girl Skate start line, it's going to be Freight Train lining up against Lexi Lightspeed. Lexi Lightspeed with a 44% lead percentage. Freight Train right with her at 43.
Freight Train, one of two Texas Roller Girls in the positive right now, and plus minus plus two. Fifi Namina plus five. Pack slowed up right at the pivot line. Freight Train one-on-one, trying to find her way past Orocha, now slowed up by Die Die. Works out. Lead jammer, Freight Train.
And that's the second lead jam in a row now for Texas. And it's going to be a forearm penalty, sending a London blocker to the back, Orocha to the box. So it's going to be a pack advantage as well. And Freight Train perils her way through for the Grand Slam.
Peace War with a great knockdown on Lexi Lightspeed. And then a penalty drawn. Texas going to lose a blocker to an elbow.
That is trauma, evening things up now in the pack, but Freight Train already around and scoring.
Freight Train pushing against that Chevron out in front. Again, Brace Tuwall in the back, dealing with Lexi Lightspeed. Arocha coming out of the box. Watch the right side of your screen. I have a feeling she might jump up and play some offense. There she goes. But Texas responding. Meanwhile, out in front, Freight Train, after pushing them to the breaking point, does break through. Grand slam. Texecutioners, 10 points so far in this jam for Freight Train.
And the star now has been passed to Jukebox, so that does free the London Jammer on her first pass.
Here comes Freight Train, one-on-one out front, one to beat in Arocha. She already has the 3 points. Will she get all four? She will not. Calls it off. Three more points on her total. 13-point jam. Makes it 118 Texas, 134 London. We have a 16-point game with just under 7 minutes to go.
Great pushback here now. A 15-0 run for the Texecutioners as they work their way back into this game. It seemed like it was getting away from them there for a while, AK, but good patience on the track, and they are now back in it. When you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick Bearings, where precision meets performance. Quick, part of the Rydell family.
Katie Black in the box means 4-3 peck advantage for Texas. Texas sending Fifi Nominon out with the star up against Rogue Runner. Rogue Runner braced two wall with a floater, now a cube. But dancing, spinning, moving around the inside and cutting the track is Rogue Runner. It is a power jam for Fifi Nominon. Big hit takes Maney down and takes the stripe off her helmet. Nice fight there with Smarty Pants.
This is the third straight lead jammer status for Texas. They are mounting a massive comeback here in the late stages of this game.
Good movement through the pack from Fifi Nominon. Locked up now by Kid Block. Offense comes. Again, great recycling. Spinning around, hitting is Shaolin Scarlet. Now, Maney dealing with Fifi Nominon. Working back and forth. Not finding room. Texas swarming, but they got to take that first blocker off. Kid Block there. Now, Fifi Nominon sprung from Kid Block, but runs right into another waiting braced two wall.
Rogue Runner out of the penalty box and quickly engaging with the Texas pack.
Takes a whip off one of her teammates and is through on her initial pass. Of course, Fifi Nominon does have lead, and she will call it as she has spun out of bounds. She did pick up all available 5 points, so a grand slam added to the total makes this an 11-point game. 134, London Brawling, 123, Texecutioners.
And London has not scored in three jams, the first time they've been held in this half at that rate. And we have now a 20-0 run for Texas as they get back into this one. As you mentioned, under 5 to go. And it looks like the first team timeout is going to be called by London. So they still have 2 left and an official review. And this team timeout is brought to you by rollergirl.ca.
Freezes the clock at 4:49. Again, 11 points in favor of London. Some late game planning right now in this timeout.
And just seeing that veteran presence from Texas, just not letting anything faze them. Seemed as at one point in this half that London was going to run away from it with it, but Texas just continued to power back and stick with their game plan. It's going to be 5-on-5 when this jam gets back underway, and on the Fast Girl State start line, it's going to be Anne Dracula, tournament leading scorer for London, against Freight Train, the tournament leading scorer for the Texas Roller Girls.
Texas setting up just in front of the Fast Girl Skate start line. Three wall across. They've got Trauma, Peace War, Stoneher, and Bittercup out there.
Interesting move right now. The London bench just completely flipping their line. Ballistic Whistle, the coach, I think, saw some matchup he did not like there and decided to go with a different line. So we'll see if this pays off.
Yep, the line for London will be Maney, Igwe, Shaolin, Scarlet, and Kid Block. Out in front of Andracula. Andracula right into Texas. Back comes Shaolin Scarlet to play offense. Peace War gets beat. Now jumping around, Andracula attempting to find room, but they're slowing her up is Trauma. Offense coming from Kid Block now, but Texas reforming. Meanwhile, in the back, taking hits is Freight Train. Now pushing up against a brace two wall, anchored by Igwe.
Igwe, a nice return to London. And it looks like we have a power jam opportunity here. A high block being assessed to Andracula. Power jam, Freight Train, and the Texas Roller Girls.
And Texas has had a slow start on their power jams. They have not been able to get their jammer out and get those big runs. Here they're going to start throwing all the offense they can at London to help Freight Train. Seems to be paying off at least a little bit, but again, London's so good at recycling. They've got Freight Train locked up in the turn.
And Texas had a skater held back. They had Igwe held back, but a penalty to Peace War freed her, and that has allowed them to bridge. But finally, lead jammer status given, a minute and 10 seconds, and Freight Train, tired, a little battered, a little bruised, now on a scoring pass.
No worse for the wear, however. 4-2 pack advantage for London as this power jam has finished. Andracula speeding out of the box, running right into that two wall of Texas, breaking it apart. Great recycle, however, by Trauma to slow her down. Flips and must release. Meanwhile, Freight Train has not moved out of the turn. As a matter of fact, she went back the other direction. Freight bumped to the infield by Igwe and calls it 2 points, 3 points. That power jam yielded 3 points. And Texas has to take advantage if they want to get back. I mean, they're not out of it, but if they want to retake this lead as they trail by 8 points, they need to be more explosive on the power jam.
Yeah, they absolutely do. But they have been doing everything right. Four straight lead jammer statuses, 23-0 run as Texas narrows the gap now to 8 points, 2:40 to go.
Both coaches on the infield having discussions. Ballistic whistle, just going to set up camp. Good movement here from Fifi Nominon, but a little too aggressive. Means it's a back block. Oh, and it's a matching penalty. Back blocks both jammers, so we're going to have a two-minute jam. We're only going to have just about, 40 seconds left in this game after this jam. Fifi in first, will get released first. Master Blaster quickly then after her. Texas trailing right now by 8. Fifi Nominon being locked up by Die Die. Meanwhile, Master Blaster speeding through, keeps those legs pumping and finishes her initial pass.
Stripe has fallen off the helmet, so there will not be an opportunity, at least right now, for a star pass. We'll see if that plays into anything, as Fifi Nominon is looking a little gas as she's taken some big hits.
Jackie Daniels, meanwhile, is the pivot, but playing defense, integral part of that defensive formation.
London now putting their first points on the board in four jams. And this could be integral in deciding the outcome of this game.
Offense coming now for London. Great job by Orocha to break things open, and 5 points go up for Master Blaster. Master Blaster has a penchant for big finishes.
Absolutely. And a big apex jump from Master Blaster was landed, and 5 more points for London.
As if on cue. We have not practiced this, folks. I mean, she has, but you know what I mean. All right, here she comes again on another scoring pass. Takes a hit right there from Jackie Daniels, and it forces the track cut, so it's going to be a power jam here for Fifi Nominon. Star in hand for 108.
A minute to go. Last chance here for Texas.
Keeps pushing forward, but London there, locked up by Die Die, is Fifi Nominon. This jam will come to a close. No more points for Texas. 2 more points for London. 12-point jam opens this one up. 20 points in favor of London. 30 seconds on the clock.
We will have time for one more jam. Texas is going to go with Freight Train on the Fast Girl Skates start line. In the pack, we are going to see Trauma, Peace War, Bittercup, and Dolores Fuertes. Responding for London is going to be Master Blaster, who is starting in the penalty box. We're going to have Steph Maney with the pivot stripe, Onyeka Igwe, Kid Block, and Shaolin Scarlet. But before we do that, we are going to take a rollergirl.ca timeout called by London. Everyone's getting an opportunity now to take a breather, set up some plays for this final jam of the championship game here in Montreal at the opening weekend of the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs.
And looking forward to the rest of those weekends. We've got next weekend in Columbia, South Carolina, then over to Vancouver, BC, Canada, and then finally finishing out Division I playoffs in Madison, Wisconsin.
Wow, cross continents coming up from the east to the west and then back right to the Midwest. It's going to be, if this is any indication of what we can expect in this year's playoffs, the Division I's are going to be an absolute treat. So get your tickets, get your viewing passes, do whatever you need to do to make sure that you are watching this tournament in 2016.
And again, we know both of these teams, as well as Montreal, are going to champs. Charlottesville, Calgary, Brandywine, and Blue Ridge are going to champs in Division II. Are you? Get your VIP tickets now before this one is over. We're going to close it out with a freight train for Texas. London keeping those packs fast. It is a power jam for the Texecutioners. Standing in the boxes, Master Blasters, freight train all the way back around a complete circum...
And Freight Train is lead jammer.
Okay, there was a penalty coming in from the outside. Penny Whistler calling a high block on Igwe. For a second, I caught my breath. I thought it was going to Freight Train. Here she comes on a scoring pass. Takes a bump there from Maney and finished out by Shaolin Scarlet in turn four. Will reset. Meanwhile, Master Blaster out of the box. Now pushing against Texas.
Freight Train coming through now on a scoring pass. It's going to take a monumental effort, though, and they are getting a little bit of help from Master Blaster, who picks up a back block penalty. Power jam for Texas.
Forearm being called on Trauma, so no star pass option for Freight Train. She's going to have to do it on her own right there. She picks up 5 points. Our score, 146 to 131. 15 points separate these teams. 1 minute remains on the clock. Everybody beginning to stand. We're going to have to stand so we can see the track.
And yes, only two blockers now on the track as Freight Train comes and approaches them. Kid Block to beat.
Kid Block working to the outfield, but Freight Train cutting the track outside. Packraft saw it. That toe stop just went out, and it will be a power jam for London. Master Blaster is released from the box. She'll have an opportunity here to close things out.
Star comes off. She's taking the star off, though, yes, and looks like it's going to be a pass to Stephanie Maney, potentially.
Track cut has Freight Train seated in the box. Jackie Daniels will now join her. Power jam moving on for London. Master Blaster looking for Maney. Fakes out the star pass. Looks for him on the outside, but is slowed up by Peace War, who flips forward facing to normal derby direction. Time winding down. Master Blaster through. No points.
5 seconds remaining. 5 seconds. It looks like London is about to lock up top spot here in Montreal.
That is it. 4 more points go up for Texas, but we have an official review coming from the Texecutioners. A 9-point jam for Texas makes it 146 to 135. London with 11-point lead, no time left on the clock. And barring a successful official review that convinces the referees to hold an additional jam, London will take home gold. Texas will take home silver, and Montreal will stay home with bronze.
And what a statement that makes about the growth of women's flat track roller derby. We've got a team from the United States going to championships. We've got a team from London, England going to championships. And we have a team from Montreal, Canada going to championships, all from this D1 tournament.
That's right. 9 more teams will be decided over the next 3 weeks. Please remember to join us here on WFTDA.tv.
And what a day it's been. We've had a 7-point game today. We had a 1-point game today. We had a 19-point game today. And now, to close things off, an 11-pointer. Unbelievable. Flat track roller derby at its absolute best.
All right, so we are in an official review for Texas again. Time has run out. 146, London, 135, Texas. And we are getting the decision now from the head ref.
And we are going to wait for a bit of an update. Our producer extraordinaire, Double H, going to get some info for us. And I'd like to take an opportunity to say some thank yous here as we wrap up this tournament. A Montreal Roller Derby would like to thank Neon Skates, Nerd Skates, Team Canada, Texas Roller Girls, and rollerskating.ca. Double H, what do you got for us?
Texas is questioning the cut call. The cut call stands, and the game is over. They don't attain their retain their official review, but nothing to retain it for. This game is in the books. London upends Texas, maintains their one seeding.
Yep.
The 2 seed stays at 2. The 4 seed has upended the 3. So again, London gold, Texas silver, Montreal bronze. Those will be awarded in the award ceremony, as well as the MVP selection out of this weekend. Derby Nerd, let's recap this game, put it in a nice little package, put a bow on it before we do the whole ceremony thing.
Yeah, well, I mean, it was an unbelievable game. Neither team was really able to take control, although London, for large stretches there of the second period, seemed to be doing just that. However, Texas, just that calm, experienced demeanor allowed them to battle their way back, and they almost made it all the way back to frantic final few jams. Lots of penalties, and London just doing an absolutely extraordinary job themselves of holding on and remaining calm in the face of that tough Texas pushback.
Speaking of penalties, final penalty counts. Barbara Ambush and Stoneherr both got into the danger zone, but we're able to finish the game with six, as well as Trauma. Helvetica Black also was knocking on heaven's door, but the level she will ascend to is for a different reason with the gold medal. How about points in this game?
Yeah, looking over at the champion London Roller Girls, leading scorer was Rogue Runner with 54 points. What a story Rogue Runner was. Just completely shut down in the first half and then just totally turned her game around in the second, coming up with 54 points despite only having a 33% lead percentage. Second in scoring was Master Blaster. Of course, she picked up that penalty but ended up coming out and being clutch there in those final moments as well.
That's right.
Followed by Lexi Lightspeed with 27, and then Anne Dracula with 31 points. Only one skater on London had 50% lead percentage, and that was Anne Dracula, continuing her phenomenal play this weekend.
And for the Texecutioners, leading scorer, Freight Train with 51 points, a plus 27. The only jammer for Texas in the plus at the end of the game. 37 points from Fifi Nominon. We also had 43 from Haas the Boss. Olivia Shute and John pulled out of the rotation early with no points, and 4 points added by Bloody Mary. All right, folks, that's the numbers. Of course, like I always say, the big number. Right there.
Yep.
146-135. London wins. We are going to take a brief break and come back for the medal ceremony as well as the selection of MVP. Derby Nerd has been an absolute pleasure, my friend.
Of course, as always.
Thank you to all for tuning in. I am AK40Ounce. He is Derby Nerd. This is WFTDA.TV. Stay tuned. We'll be back for the closing ceremony in just a little bit.